In this example, we're going to take a given direction field and then sketch the solutions through various points. So first of all, let's just think for a second about what a direction field represents. So here I'm given a particular differential equation, dy dt equals y minus t. So in this notation, y represents the unknown solution to the differential equation. And then t, or sometimes it'll be x, is my independent variable. So what this is saying is that there's some unknown function y of t that solves this differential equation. And I'm told that the derivative of that function, dy dt, equals y minus t. Now remember what the derivative tells us about the function. The derivative of a function tells us about its slope. And that's what the direction field essentially gives us visually. So this direction field gives us the slope of our function y of t, our unknown function y of t, at various points. So even though we don't actually know what y of t is, we can know a lot about what it looks like from the direction field. So basically what happens, and we'll learn more about this very shortly, basically what happens to actually draw these direction fields is you simply plug in some point on the ty plane. So I'd pick a point and I'd plug it in to dy dt equals y minus t, and I'd get some value. Let's say I got a value of 1. That would mean that the slope at that point would be 1, so I'd just draw a little line segment with a slope of approximately 1. And that's how these direction fields are created. So one of the cool things about direction fields is we can sort of sketch in some particular solutions that go through certain points just by sort of following the flow of the direction field. So let's see what that's going to look like. I want to sketch the solution through these various points, 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 1, 1. You could try this through any point, really. So let's start with the 0, 1. I want to sketch the solution that goes through the point 0, 1, so this point right here. So how am I going to do this? So remember we just said these little line segments are giving us the slope of the solution. So you can kind of think of them as giving you the flow of the solution. They're telling you in which direction the solution should go. So I actually picked a really easy one to start out with here. If I look at the way these lines are pointing, I can kind of see that my solution that goes to this point, if I follow the slope, is just going to be this nice straight line like this. I'm just following the flow of these slopes to sketch the solution. Okay, so that's part A. Let's try drawing a solution through a different point. Let's see. Let's do part B, which is 0, negative 1. So this one's a little bit more challenging, right? It doesn't look like it's just going to be a straight line. It's some sort of curved solution here. Now, I'm actually going to make this just a little bit easier for us. In my computer program here, I can actually increase the density of these lines. So let's increase that a little bit. Okay, so I want to kind of use the same idea. I'm just going to follow as best as I can the flow or the slope of these lines to sketch in my solution. Okay, so if I do that, I'm going to start by going to the left. It looks like I should be slanting up and then flattening out, and then it looks like now I kind of go down in this direction, right? My slopes are negative. So maybe something kind of like that. And then I want to do the other side. All these slopes in this general region are negative, and they're pretty steep, so it looks like maybe something like this. These are just sketches of solutions. Okay, so let's do finally part C, the solution through point 1, 1. Okay, so point 1, 1 is here. And once again, I'm just going to follow the flow of my little lines. So it looks like right there at point 1, 1, I'm kind of on a flat, maybe a flatter part of the curve. See, I've got these horizontal tangent lines, but then to the left and to the right, it looks like I should sort of drop off. So Maybe I'm sort of at a maximum. And then on either side, I kind of follow this downward motion. Okay, so maybe something like that. Okay, so actually, this computer program can sketch in the solutions. So I'm going to do that now just to show you more exactly what they would look like. So if I just add those in green here, it actually looks like we did pretty good for ourselves in sketching these. Here's what the actual shapes look like. So this is basically how to get an idea of what a solution to a differential equation through a certain point looks like. So these direction fields are pretty cool, right? We can sketch these solutions. Another thing to start thinking about is that sometimes the direction field can help us think about long-term behavior. So what happens to the solutions in general as t gets larger and larger. That might be something else you might want to start thinking about as you look at these kind of problems. So just from the few lines I have here, and I can even add in one more line on the other side of this horizontal line. So even just from these few lines I have here, it sort of looks like as t goes to negative infinity, these curves are approaching this diagonal straight line. And then from the few I have, once again, it looks like maybe as t goes to infinity, they're sort of curving away from that horizontal line. So these are all interesting and important things to think about when you're working with direction fields.